In the last video, we talked about the disadvantages of batch learning and how that can be solved with online learning. In this video, we will talk about how to use River to do machine learning in Python. To install River, type pip install River. The code of this project can be found in the repository qingqiang1401/data-science. You can find the link to this repository in the description of the video. Let's start the tutorial with loading a sample dataset. Specifically, we will load the penguins dataset from Seaborn. If we look at the information of this dataset, we can see that the species column will be the target, while the rest of the columns will be the features for the model. With that information, we divide the data into X and Y. After preparing the data, we are ready to create an ML pipeline with River. We will start with import some useful libraries from River. In online learning, observations are provided one at a time. We will mimic this behavior by iterating through each row of two pandas data frame, X and Y, with stream.eaterPandas. In this for loop, each XI and YI is one observation. Now, let's run this and see how the last observation looks like. It is a dictionary of features, names, and their values. And YI is simply a value. Since there are some missing values in the dataset, we will compute the missing values with the mean of the dataset. To find the mean of the dataset, we will add up n non-null values in the dataset and divide the result by n. This is a pretty standard way to impute missing values. However, in online learning, we can't apply the same procedure to compute the mean, since we don't know the values of the entire dataset. Thus, we will use running statistics to estimate the mean instead. To compute the running mean, update the mean whenever there is a new value. Then use that running mean to update the missing value. In River, we can use preprocessing doc.imputer to impute the missing values with a running statistic. In this case, we will use mean as our running statistic. For each example, we will update the statistic with the learnOne method, then use transform1 to transform that observation. LearnOne is similar to scikit-learn-fit method, and transform is similar to scikit-learn-transform method, except that fit and transformed are applied to a batch of data, while learnOne and transform1 are only used on an observation. Let's run this and see what we got. Cool, we can see that the outputs are similar to what we found earlier. River Compose provides several methods to build a machine learning pipeline. Let's use these methods to create a pipeline that transforms categorical and numerical features. These methods are similar to scikit-learn-mech pipeline and scikit-learn-column-transformer, which applies different transformers depending on the type of features. To create a pipeline to transform categorical features with River, start with select the features of type object. Next, we use pipe to pass the output of the last transformer to the next transformer. We use dataset and one-hot encoder as a transformer for categorical features. The transformers for the numerical features use a similar approach. Lastly, we combine the transformer for the numerical features and categorical features into one pipeline. Let's try out this pipeline by learning from an observation, then transform that observation. And this is the output after applying the pipeline to one observation. Finally, we will use a decision tree algorithm to learn from the data. Traditional batch decision trees can't cope with online learning requirements, since they need to be retrained with the entire dataset when there are new observations. Thus, we will use the Hoffding tree classifier for online learning instead. Hofding tree is the most popular family of incremental decision trees to date. To use Hofding tree in River, we will use this class. Now, let's combine the transformers and the classifiers into one pipeline with the function getPipeline. When we run this function, we'll get a pipeline that looks like this. Let's use this pipeline to create a function that makes predictions and trains the model on a stream of data. In this code, we first start with calling the getPipeline function we created earlier to get the pipeline. Next, we use RiverMetrics module to initialize some metrics such as F1 score and confusion metrics. We will use F1 scores to store the F1 score for each iteration. The next step is to iterate over the dataset. For each observation, we will predict the new sample, evaluate the prediction, and update the scores. Lastly, we train the model with the new sample, and we will repeat this process over and over again for each observation in the dataset. And at the end, we return the F1 score, the confusion matrix, and the pipeline. Now let's observe the outputs of this function. First, we will get a summary of the classifier. Here we can see that the parameters of the classifier are updated with certain values. Next, let's create a function to create a line plot that shows the change in the score as the iteration increases. We can see that the micro F1 score reaches the highest value around the 150th iteration and then decreases afterward. Another way that we can evaluate the model's performance is through the progressive val score method. This method takes a dataset, the model, and the metric. If print every equal 50, then River will print the metric every 50 iterations. From the output, we can see the micro F1 score for every 50 iterations and the micro F1 score of the last iteration. The final score is pretty low. Let's dive deeper into the model performance by viewing the confusion matrix. We can see that the majority of the false predictions are classified as ideally species. This could be because the data is imbalanced. Let's confirm this by looking at the count for each value in Y. When inspecting the value of Y, we can see that there are more ideally labels than other labels. In the next video, we will learn how to deal with imbalanced dataset with River.